first pitch of the night coming up shortly from Citi Field. It's the Yankees and the Mets, and it's coming up next. Now from the borough of Queens in Flushing, New York, MLB The Show has baseball from beautiful Citi Field. Tonight, we've got a good matchup in store between the New York Yankees and their crosstown rivals, the New York Mets. Hi, folks. Matt Vasgersian welcoming you to another installment of the Subway Series. I'll be joined in just a minute by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, but first, let's take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting New York Yankees as Joe Girardi's starting nine assembles this way. See the starting pitcher they'll match up against as you look at his numbers on the right side of your screen. Jacoby Ellsbury will stand in for the first time here. And this ball will be chopped foul. And this is heading out toward left field, but this is going to get fouled up into the crowd. Here's another 1-2. Ah, trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Oh, and he's waiting on the fastball that time as he belts one high and deep to right center. And he will start the ball game in style. It's a home run. A solo shot for Jacoby Ellsbury as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead.
Well, I'll tell you, having a guy at the top of the lineup that's capable of doing this, boy, that's a great weapon to have. He jumps all over this ball to lead off the ball game with a solo home run.
Derek Jeter will take his first cuts now, and after the leadoff home run to start the ball game, does the game plan change at all from a pitching perspective?
Well, I think it's a little bit more of a shock to the system than anything else. You're just not expecting that leadoff guy to be the guy that takes you deep.
To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. No outs, nobody on. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, and he'll take this to the bag, 3 unassisted for the first out. So he's able to bounce back here following the leadoff home run, and with that, let's take a look at the defense for the New York Mets. It's brought to us by Majestic, the official uniform of Major League Baseball. Carlos Beltran will dig with 1 in and 1 away. 1 out, nobody on. Here's a bouncing ball now up the middle, and it's going to sneak its way into center field for a 1-out base hit.
A a good job there making a two-strike adjustment. Very compact there. He uses the middle of the field, and this just finds its way into center for a base hit.
Brian McCann will stand in with a run in, one out, and one on here in the inning. And he takes a good swing at that one as this is sent down the line in right, but ultimately into the crowd of foul ball. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. Throw over to the bag, and he just manages to get his hand in. Lead by Beltran, and now the pitch. Now here's another pitch fouled off and heading for the seats, and he's just fighting to stay alive here, still 2-2. He's running toward second. Now a slider is lined toward the gap in left center, and that's going to be down for extra bases. Now third base coach Rob Thompson's going to wave him on home. And he will pull into second with a double.
I tell you what, anytime you get a first inning visit from your pitching coach, something ain't working out there. You know, here's what he's saying. Look, we need you to figure this out. We need some innings out of you here. Let's go.
The first baseman, Mark Teixeira, will stand in looking to keep this first inning rally hot. Now a ball lined to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit.
And I got a feeling the last thing these guys want to do is get someone up in the bullpen here in the first inning. And they might not have a choice because this is four hits against them already. And that last one was smoked.
Runners on the corners now with one man gone. And standing in is the dangerous Alfonso Soriano. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Well, you know, three straight hits are bad enough, but now he's making things even worse by falling behind the next guy.
Here it comes, 2-1. Oh, he took a big swing that time as he lifts a high pop up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Duda is over now, and he's got it for out number two.
A nice comeback there to get the pop-up. Now with two-way, let's see if he can find a way out of this mess.
Brian Roberts, we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home here in the inning so far. Center field. Lagares is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. So it's two runs on four base hits, no errors, and a couple of men left on. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. The Yankees lead it 2-0. Now here's the starting lineup for the Mets as put forward by manager Terry Collins. They'll match up against the big fella, the hard-throwing left-hander C.C. Sabathia. And a They'll look now at the defensive alignment for the Yankees behind him. Eric Young Jr. will dig in here. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
And even just four pitches in, you need to find a strike here because you don't want to give him a free base runner to start the night.
On the ground to the second baseman, Roberts. And a toss by Roberts is in time, one away.
That's a nice backhanded play there at second. You'd like to be able to get in front of this ball if you can, but here he does a nice job of looking it into the glove, and then he makes a throw to first for the out.
Juan Lagares will get his first cuts here. Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Up and in here as he had to bend out of danger.
And we're going to see a lot more of this because this is a guy who's let it be known that he will work inside. He'll even back you off the plate if he has to.
Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2. Waiting in the on-deck circle is David Wright. And on 3-2, he delivers a line drive out to left center. That's going to split the defenders out there for extra bases. And he is in at second base with a one-out double. So a runner aboard at second here with one away. And stepping in, the all-star third baseman, David Wright. And he wouldn't have made contact with that one with an oar. It's 2-2.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
The 2-2 now to right, and now the runner's trying for third. And a liner foul into the seats down the right side. And this is hit sharply toward the third base coaching box, a foul ball. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And this is fouled straight back. And a little battle brewing here as he fights off the two-strike pitch and chops it foul. Grounded to third. Throw to first is in time to take care of Wright, and that's the second out. Curtis Granderson will stand in now, the possessor of a new four-year deal signed in the offseason.
Yeah, it turned out to be quite a sales job getting him here, but they were able to lock him up for the next 4 years, and I think both sides are really happy with the way things turned out.
Take him deep!
Check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three and the inning is over. Mets strand one. They trail things here 2-0. Kelly Johnson leads things off now in the top half of the second. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. CC Sabathia will be the batter. Swung on and missed. 1-2 now. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
Looks like he's finding his bearings here a little bit better in the second after a rough first inning. He gets the strikeout right here, but boy, he could have used one of these an inning ago, that's for sure.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in the center fielder, Jacoby Ellsbury. Now the pitch home to Ellsbury. And he swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. Ligaris is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Bombers, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Lucas Duda will lead things off here as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. And this is fouled back and out of play. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Right over the top here with the four-seam fastball. Good drive through the release. Just threw it right by him at the letters.
Daniel Murphy digs in at the plate. A little bit outside, 2-1. Now a swing as he rifles this one into center for a base hit.
You talk about getting the bat head out front. This is rifled up the middle. Can't square up a baseball any better than that.
Travis d'Arnaud will get his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. And a fastball swung on and hit in the air to left. There to take it is Soriano, and he does so for the second out of the inning. Ruben Tejada will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Here's a line drive that's going to get over the head of Jeter and on into left center. That's a base hit.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller, the thought is that you've got to get out there and hit the ball before it sinks. So that means if you're a right-handed hitter, you got to jump out there and pull it. And that's exactly what he did.
Dylan G will get a shot now with two on and two out here in inning number two. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Two left for the Mets. They're down 2-0. Back with Eric Harris and Steve Lyons, Matt Vasgersian, as Derek Jeter gets set to lead off the inning here for the Yankees. Quick bat by Jeter there, but a little too quick as this is pulled foul into the stands in left. Now a swing and a fly ball. And that gets down for a leadoff single for Jeter.
Well, this is already a 2-0 game, and now the leadoff man's on again here to start the third. We've got a chance now to really open things up early and build up a nice, comfortable lead.
Carlos Beltran will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. A runner at first with no outs here. Look at Jeter, now the pitch. And Beltran able to lay off that time, and the count moves back to 2-2. And a swing and a miss that time by Beltran, and he's set down on strikes for the first out.
And here you go from behind the plate. This is a good angle to show how that four-seam fastball will rise at the end. And that's a pitch that's awfully difficult to get on top of.
Brian McCann will stand in, an RBI double to his credit the first time around. Curveball, and he couldn't get on top of it as this has popped up behind shortstop. Tejada takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out.
And there's a look at his pitch count so far. You can see he's already thrown 37 pitches for strikes. That shows me that he's been able to work the zone effectively to this point.
So it's a runner at first with two gone. And here's the dangerous Mark Teixeira. And a good fastball here as he pops him up back behind second base. Tejada will put this one away, and the side is retired. One left for the Yankees as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Eric Young Jr. makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. That's on the corner to put him behind now, 1-2. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now another pitch is hit foul and headed for the seats, so the count will stay put at 1-2. Here he comes again, 1-2. And now a swing and a ball hit in the air out to left field. Drifting under it now is Soriano, and he pulls it in for the first out.
And you'll see where this pitch is. It's up, but it's up far enough that he can't quite get on top of it. And he winds up lifting a lazy fly ball.
Juan Lagares will stand in here. He doubled his first time around. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
And even on 0-2, you don't want guys to get into a comfort level up there.
Now the 1-2. Lined hard to center field. Ellsbury is there, two gone.
Yeah, he timed that curveball perfect. Kept his weight back and drilled it to center field, but hung up there just a little too long for him.
David Wright will come forward now, the starting third baseman on last year's NL All-Star team. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And Beltran will pull this one in, and that will retire the side. Nice job there by CC Sabathia. His guys lead it 2-0.